Hey guys, good morning. Welcome back to Farming Simulator 2015. It's a Friday morning. We're just coming up to 7 a.m. And as you can see in the top right hand corner, we've actually got some cash, which is totally unheard of for us. Now, if you've been watching, you'll know that we've harvested, if you like, or collected and sold our first load of silage. And that's where the money's come from. I had no idea there was so much money in silage. Makes you wonder why any farmer would ever do anything else. But anyway, we have a source of income now, and in addition to that, field 23 is almost ready to harvest. I say almost because it's only about 80% ready, but that 80% is ready to harvest right now. And having lost an entire field's worth just on Tuesday, if you watched that episode, we lost an entire crop of corn on Tuesday because we didn't harvest it quick enough. So first thing to do today is get the harvester out and get him working. Now say only 80% of the field is ready, so instead of going round and round, we're gonna go up and down today. And because of that, I've actually just decided we're gonna start at the bottom so that when the harvester is full, the pipe will be out over the swath and not over the crop. Hope that makes sense. So whilst we're slowly journeying down here in the harvester preparing to set up, I'd like to speak to you about this series and my channel and what's going on in my head. So it doesn't appear that this series is actually gaining much interest with you guys. Now, I'm not entirely sure why that is. It could well be me, it could well be the content. If you don't know, this farm is being run with ultimate realism, which means no switching between tractors and no auto switching between tractors, and a whole host of other mods have been applied as well to really boost the level of authenticity. What's he doing? Whoa. I want you to go up and down that way. Can you manage that? Why are you going left? I don't want you to go left. I want you to go up and down. I want you to go south to north. Alright, let's just start this off ourselves and hopefully you'll get the idea. So yeah, we don't appear to have many followers or any followers, to be quite honest with you. So this is week four. We're just coming up to the last day, which will be tomorrow of week four. And now that we've actually got some money coming in, we can start doing some interesting stuff. But if the reality is that nobody is actually enjoying this series and nobody's actually watching this series, then there seems little point in continuing. Now, if you are the one person who's interested in seeing more, then please leave me a comment just saying you'd like me to continue. What I'm going to do, the plan is that next week, being week five for this series, I shall continue working towards the goal, which is clearing off the debt and recovering enough cash to be able to move to a new farm. And that new farm could be any of the newly released farms. So, I mean, watch that series next week. If you're interested, please leave me a comment saying, yes, I'm enjoying this. Please don't quit. And if nobody contacts me, then I'll take that as meaning that the series is not of interest to anyone. And week 5 will be the last week. We shan't move on to the new farm. So if that's not something you want to happen, let's see if he does it the right way this time. That's a bit better. So if that is not something you want... Oh, crikey. I do apologise. If you want me to continue, then you need to leave me a comment in the comment section, basically. So that's enough of that spiel. So yeah, we hired a new Holland T4 with a front loader, and we managed to go and sell quite a bit of silage. We've got about 90,000 litres left, which is about €100,000. So the idea is to get field 23 harvested and then plant some grass here and really, really push the silage. Had a terrible time with this tractor completely getting stuck and driving into buildings and all sorts of bloody annoying stuff. Been a real, real nightmare. Sorry, completely off track. Right, so yes, yesterday we hired a new Holland T4, the Power Star. And it did the job perfectly, really did. But it was only hired, so that's probably gone back by now. And we actually have the finances to buy one. So that's what I'd like to do today. Ka-ching! And also we're going to need a front loader. Ka-ching! And we're going to need a bucket. Where's the bucket? There we go. And one other thing I'd like to buy is this, the log fork. Now we have to go pick all this stuff up from the shop, which means I have to literally walk there, which is potentially a bit of a pain in the ass for me, but you guys won't have to see that. So I'm going to run down there and I am going to pick up our new tractor and I'll see you there. It doesn't appear that there are many people watching this series at the moment, which is a shame for me. I don't know if it's because the content isn't good enough. I don't know if it's because I'm not good enough. Maybe there's just not enough interest in Farming Simulator 2015. I'm not entirely sure what the situation is, but I'm releasing a video every day. It's taking a lot of time to play the game, record the game, edit the game, render the game, and then upload the game. It's consuming a lot of my time. So the idea was that we clear our debts, take all of our earnings and buy a new farm with it. But if nobody's actually interested in seeing that happen, then I might as well knock this series on the head, and then I can focus on other things. So if there's just one person who would like to see this farm evolve in consistency with the ultimate realism ethos, then please leave me a comment saying such. If I don't get any comments from anybody, then I'll assume that no one is interested and I will cease and desist. So next week, unless I hear from somebody who's interested in the series continuing, will be the last week of Farming Simulator 2015. What I wanted to do today, whilst we have a bit of cash, is just try out a bit of lumberjacking. for want of a better word. So where is the... Oh, okay, it's down there. Now, I've never done this before. Totally new to it. So all I've done is I've bought a log fork for the front of the tractor. And I'll be giving it a go. I don't even know where the forest is, to be honest with you. I've just looked on the map. And we're going to head to the lumber yard because... Instinctively, I expect there's going to be a field or two, a forest or two in that sort of general area. What the heck is this thing? I've never been up this end of the map. There's so much I haven't done on this game, it's ludicrous. What is this thing? It's like a circus or something. I've never seen that. There's so much I haven't done in this game. When I first got this game, I was so disappointed with the lack of development that I just kind of put it back on the shelf and didn't bother with it again. But look at that, that's so cool. And it's only the modders that have made this game worth playing, in my opinion. Oh wow, look at these bridges. There's so much I haven't seen here, I'm so sorry. This is all new to me. Let's go down to the big bridge, I want to see what the big bridges are. Oh, listen to that water. Sorry, I just got to get out for a second here. Whoa, crikey, nearly flipping jumped off the bridge. Oh, I could just sit and listen to that for hours. That's fabulous. Oh, wow. I wish I lived here. Yeah, I'm looking for a forest to cut down a tree. And touch wood, haven't had any bad news from the harvesting team. I can see they're still moving, so that's promising. Because the whole point of having course play and... Oh look, there's the lumber yard. Cool. I have already played this once today, and I didn't actually manage to get to cut down any trees because the course play kept crashing, so which is why I just rebuilt the course play. But yeah, I didn't actually manage to get any trees cut down at all, so I still have never done that. This will be the first time I've ever done it. I think there's a forest over here somewhere. I didn't even get to the point where I found the forest, so... I think this is the forest, and I don't know that for sure, but I think this is the forest. I suppose the only way to tell, or the best way to find out, oh crap now, is a bit of a key binding issue there, is to chop a tree down. Now if I chop that one down, it'd probably fall on the tractor and smash it to bits. So let's go over here and find one that's on a hill and far enough away that we not... Hee hee! How cool is this? Right, I don't really know what I'm doing. So I've sussed out that if I hold the right mouse button down, I get my angle. And obviously I don't want this tree to fall on me. So I think I just cut a wedge, don't I? Right. Oh, I did it! Okay. I think, preferably, I cut that too straight. Oh crikey, what do I do now? Let's try putting more of an angle on it. My god, is this the most resilient tree on the planet? Oh, there's a... Yeah, as you can see, I'm not really... Ah, there we go. Ah, there we go. What the heck? I've cut this tree... I've cut it three times and it's still standing. Oh, right, okay, I'm with you. Kind of. Can I cut it lower? No. It doesn't seem to want to cut when I'm lower down. I'm struggling to get this to get in position, really. Ah, there we go, there we go. There we are, Tim Barr. Woohoo! That's awesome! Now I'm hoping the other trees will stop it from rolling off. Yes! We cut a tree down! Woohoo! The first one ever. Now, I've seen some videos of people like chopping the branches off and things. Ooh. I'm really struggling with this. And now I've climbed up a tree. That's not what we wanted. Now I don't really know if I'm cutting the branches off or just... Oh, it looks like I am. Yeah, that's working. Okay. I'm finding it a little bit difficult to figure out where the chainsaw is actually looking. See, for the life of me, I can't seem to aim at the branch I'm interested in cutting. How are we looking there? Oh yeah, look at that. Nice. Look at that. That's quite a big tree actually. That's not bad for my first tree. Now, obviously I'm going to have to cut this up into manageable sizes. So, in my head, let's put this away before I kill myself. In my head, oh goodness me. In my head, this requires me to get the tractor over here and lift the tree. Now, I haven't used this before, so it's probably going to take me a bit of time getting used to the angles and the shape and the sizes and stuff. Whoa! Okay. One thing I have noticed, which is really stupid of me, is that I have not got a weight on the back of this flipping tractor. And I'm guessing that this tree is probably too heavy. Let's just see if I can move it at all. Yeah, well, okay, I can move it. And it is struggling. Crikey. Right, let's just hold it. Keep it like that for now. The tractor doesn't look too happy, does it? Right, let's see if we can't trim this down a bit. What happened there then? Why didn't that cut in half? Is it because it's moving? I think it's because it's moving, isn't it? Yes, look at that. Alrighty. It's actually a bit more frustrating than I had anticipated. The fact that I've forgotten to put the weight on the back of the tractor is a terrible annoyance. So look at that, we got some logs. That's pretty cool. Now, let's see if this tractor is man enough to pick one up. Should we start with the big one? If we can do the big one, we can do all of them, can't we? So, that's my weird logic. I think I'm going to try it from the other side. Now, this could all go horribly wrong. And just to prove that, we got stuck already. Now, I'm all in favour of doing in-cab Damn it. That's just too heavy, that one. Let's try one of the smaller ones first then. You see I'm learning as I'm going here. I can't believe I didn't put a weight on the back of the tractor. That was silly. Let's try this tiny little one, see if we can't even pick that up. I mean, it is a tractor, for goodness sakes, it must have some weight. Now, we've also got this added concern of getting stuck in here. It's not the most friendly of areas, just using the arm there to get me out of that trouble. We don't want to get stuck in on a hill or something like that. That would be terrible. So we've got a bit of cash available to us. It might be a good idea to buy a really heavyweight. Okay. It looks like we found a tree that we can lift. It's a tiny little bit of a tree. It's not much of a tree. I shouldn't imagine it's going to bring any money in. But it is our first time of doing this, so just the simple fact of achieving actually doing it is something of a success. It's really hard in this forest. Crikey. Just to do anything. Now, not having a weight on the back of this tractor is a real, real problem. Oh my lord. And now those two have got themselves confused. So it looks like I'm going to have to go back up to field 23 anyway, just to fix those two. I might as well grab a weight whilst I'm there. Whoa. Just the right length, this one, I think. But okay, what are your guesses? How much is this going to bring in? I think we might get somewhere between 500 and 1,000 for this little bit of tree. Not even that much. 335. So, yeah, that didn't bring in a great deal of cash. It wasn't a great deal of tree, to be fair. Let's go back to 23 and get those guys sorted out. Oh, wow, there's... Whoa, 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 you crazy, crazy man. There's people walking around. I've never seen that before. Not like this anyway. Where the hell are they all going? Oh, wow. I've never seen that before. That's so cool. That just looks so awesome. Sorry, I'm sure you've seen that a million times. Right, we want to go this way, don't we? Oh look, it's the shop. I know where I am now. And that should, theoretically, make picking up trees a possibility. If not, I'll just have to cut them into smaller pieces, I guess. Now, playing with ultimate realism does have its downsides, and this is one of them. You know, when you've automated a harvest, for example, and they have an issue, you've got to drive all the way back and fix it. That's just the way it is. But you know, that does add for authenticity, and we're struggling to get up here with this weight on the back. Goodness me. So it seems like they haven't actually crashed, they've just got in each other's way. Well, they really have got in each other's way as well. Like, I mean, goodness me. What are you doing, chaps? Oh, crikey. Oh, there you go, there's a bit of realism for you. Nearly destroyed some of the crops by not putting the handbrake on and having the tractor roll straight in through the crops there. Okay, so that's those two sorted. It's difficult to tell from here, but it looks like the rest of the field has reached maturity. Yes it has. So that's great. So that should be that should all finish now without too much issue. And we can head back to the forest if we've got time. It's 3 o'clock already. It's going to be tight. Maybe we'll have enough time to get one or two logs in and see how much revenue that brings in before the end of today's episode. So once again, if you are enjoying the episode, please hit the like button to let me know that you're enjoying it. If you're not enjoying it, and there's a reason why you're not enjoying it, please share that with me, because I'm very new to YouTube. I've only been doing this a short time, and I'm just doing what I think is best. And if I'm mistaken in what I'm doing, if it would be better not being on this farm, for example, I don't know. Whatever the reason is, please let me know, because I'm very passionate about producing decent content, or excellent content, if I can, for you to enjoy. And if I'm not doing that, I'd like to know what I can change. Oh, crikey. You didn't see that, right? We was not here. Yeah, just let me know what I can do to make this more interesting for you. And if you really, really genuinely don't care, you know, you can even leave me a message saying that I'm rubbish, this is boring, you don't want to see any more. And I'll take that into consideration as well. So anyway, that's pretty much all we can do. That's pretty much all I can say. Was it just rolling up for 4 o'clock? See if we can get one of the big logs sold and just experience what it's like to be a lumberjack for 5 minutes. But we'll have a go at the big one. Now, once I've got some sort of experience of using this, I'll do it from within the cab. But for now, I don't know why I'm so far out. That's a bit too far out, isn't it? For now, I kind of need to learn what I'm doing, so I think we are at the absolute limit that we can manage. In fact, we might be slightly over the limit that we can manage, and that's not very central, is it? That's going to make life a bit more difficult. How the heck am I going to get this thing out of here? Pick it up slightly more in the middle, because that's not making things any easier, picking it up like that. That was awesome, it kind of rolled into us. Alrighty. Note to self, cut a tree down near the entrance. Now, I'm just going to tank it and try and get up that hill. I don't know if we're going to manage it, but God, go on, go on. Yes! I've really made life difficult for us by cutting a tree down so deep into the forest. I should have just done one of these ones on the outside. But we're through and we're back on the track, and this is cool. Now this is a proper bit of tree. So we got 334 for the first one. What do you think this one's going to be worth? This is going to be 1,000, isn't it? If the other one was 334 and it was a skinny, small piece of tree, are we going to fit through? Oh no, look at that! Oh crikey. All these things that I'm learning about how not to do this. This looks like an easier route. Does it go where I want it to? That's the question. Oh, blimey. So it's just rolling up to 5 o'clock. Whoa, steady on. I'll sell this one and we'll call it a day. So thank you very much for watching today. Remember, if you want me to continue this series, you're going to have to say so, because there's so few people watching it. And even if there's only one guy or girl who's interested in me continuing this series, then I will. But I need to hear from somebody, because at the moment it just seems like I'm not doing anything that's of interest to anybody. So here we go. How much do you think we've got for this one tree? I'm going to predict 1,200. That's my complete guess. 3,124. Wow, that's not bad actually. As you can see, I haven't quite mastered the controls of this. So that's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. Please hit the like button if you liked this episode, and please let me know if you want me to continue. Goodbye for now.